starting with numerical number 13. Now here, a simple pendulum performs simple harmonic motion of period 4 seconds. So here we have time period 4 seconds. How much time after crossing the mean position? How much time? If they are telling it time period, then it will be capital T. If you are telling it time, then it is small t. How much time after crossing the mean position, means phi is equal to 0, the displacement of the bob, that is x, will be 1/3 of its amplitude. This is the condition given to you. So first you'll have to find out the formula of displacement, that is A sine omega t plus phi. Here we know that phi is 0. So the formula is A sine omega t. Now here we don't have the value of omega. Omega is nothing but 2 pi n. But do you have n in the formula or n in the question? Sorry, n is frequency. Do you have the value of frequency given in the question? No. So we also know that frequency is equal to 1 upon time period. And we have the value of time period. So we will write in place of n 1 upon t. So from here we can calculate omega. What is x equal to 1 upon 3a? Here also you have a. Sine, in place of omega, you can write 2 pi upon capital T and this small t. Now this a and this a gets cancelled. Now you have 1 upon 3, that is 3 ones are 3 0 0 point. So this becomes 10. This is a 9. 1 is left because of point, that becomes 10. So this continues. So we will keep it 0.333, which is equal to sine 2 pi upon capital T and this small t. Now if you take this sine on left hand side, that becomes sine inverse of 0.333, which is equal to 2 pi upon capital T. The value of capital T is 4 and the small t is left over here. Now we will check in the logbook for the value of this digit. We will go in natural sine. Now it is 0.33 and then 3. 0.33. If you see, here you have 3. After that the 4th digit is 8. If you notice over here, here you just have 2, 3. And even here you have 2, 3. But in this case, you have 3, 3, 3, which is similar to this digit. So we will check. In which degree does it comes? If you check it over here, it comes for 19 degree. And when you check in this column, it is 0.5 degree. That is this 19.5 degree. Here the value will be 19.5 degree, which is equal to 2 pi upon capital 4 and this t. Now this is in degree. I want the value of time in seconds, of course. So I'll convert this degree into radian. So 19.5 into pi upon 180. Now this is in radians. So that is 2 pi upon 4 and this t over here. This pi and this pi will obviously get cancelled. Take this 4 over here. So this becomes 19.5 into 4. Okay, you can also do it like this. So take this 2 over here upon 180, which is equal to t. 2 ones are 2 nines are 18, 2 zeros are 0. So now you have 19.5 upon 90, which I am writing as 9 into 10, which is equal to small t. Now if you take this 10 in the numerator, this becomes 10 raised to minus 1 upon 9, which is equal to t. 9 ones are 9. 9 2s are 18 point, this becomes 15. So again 9 1s are 9. So you have 6 left with you because of point, that becomes 60. 9 6 are 54. So again 6 is left with you. So this continues. So it is 2.1666 into 10 raised to minus 1, that is equal to 50. Now if you multiply this 10 raised to minus 1 in this digit, the point will of course shift towards this side because this side is of negative side of number line. So and to one digit we are going to shift. So this becomes 0.21666 seconds is equal to the time which we were asked to calculate.